So hello and welcome to the GP2 Offline Championship 2009 season, and here we are for the round 2 in Spain. So I'm assuming you're commentator for this highlight, and you are going to see the grid for this race. And Trident got another pole position once again, but with this time with different driver. John Arthur is on pole, and then alongside is Adam Kem. Rifki Park reside in 3rd place, and 4th place is Roman Quek. This is the same like the last race, 3rd and 4th. And you have 5th, Mario Rossi is in 5th, Levente Dobos in 6th, then you have Nico Tauber is in 7th, and Spencer Hodson is in 8th, and Tobias Kress, his teammate, will start 9th, and Sasha Banks alongside him will start 10th. Robert Ionescu, row 6, will start 11th, then alongside him is Bruno De Barros in 12th, Darwin Greenwood is in 13th, Hakan Sam in 14th, and behind Greenwood is his teammate Rinchens, 15th, and alongside him is Amacha, the previous race winner, and is about to start in 16th, Petro Mocha in 17th, Mario McLary in 18th, and next to him is Eric Vettel in 19th, Gabriel Gomez 20, and Sonny Brooklyn in 21st, and Carpo Hautala in 22nd replaces Christian Garcia, who raced for GP4 Offline Championship, replaces Arthur Zafri. And here it is the weather forecast. We're going to have a dry race, so no any rain. So on to the grid then. John Arthur is on pole position. He is on the right on your screen. Then you have alongside him is Adam Kem. Fiery lights before the race gets underway for the second round of GP2 Offline Championship is underway, and it's a good start by Adam Kem, and it's a good start as well by the Rifki Park Rizal. So Randy moves up into second place. Now down inside, can he take the lead of the race? Later in the ring, can he take the lead of the race? Fantastic start by Rifki Park Rizal, and there's a contact between Kress and the one of the racing engineering car. I believe that is Rizal. And as they approaches turn number 4, Park Rizal leads the race. Fantastic start by him. He just made up 2 positions at the start, and Arthur dropped down into second, and Kem down into third place, and Quack still stays in fourth. But it looks like Adam Kem not have a good start, because he just holds many car behind him. As you can see, there's a several car trying to get past the car in front of him, trying to make up some position at the start. And here is the race leader, Fakri Zain, who leads away from John Arthur. Fantastic start by the Indonesian driver. And it looks like there's an overtake, Hudson versus Tauber in front of him. Is it Tauber's in 7th place? As you can see, there's a one of the racing engineering down inside, makes a move, and there's a lock up by someone, and it looks like everybody just keep his car on track safely at the moment. So we are about to complete the first lap of the race. Fakri Zain leads from Arthur, 2/10 to the second is the gap between the race leader and Arthur. Then you have 3rd place is Adam Kem, and here it is the race leader. Now he just increases his gap to 4/10 to the second. This is Tauber versus Hodson for 7th place, looking down inside, side by side between them, side by side, and around the outside. Can he make it move? Not quite this time. Tauber defends, and Hodson is going to find another way, trying to get past this guy in front of him. As we skip now for a moment, as you can see, there's a race leader, Rifki Park Rizal, and still defense from Arthur. And it looks like Arthur is closing to Park Rizal, and we got a several battle at the back. And Gomez moves up into 18th place. There's a mistake at the back. Someone did a mistake there. It looks like going slowly. I believe that is Gomez. So Gomez, yes, Gomez already dropped down into 19th place. So what I can say is still a clean race. So we are about to complete the second lap of the race. As you can see on your screen, there's a driver switch to the fast lap of the race. It's Fakri Zain who leads, and it looks like Arthur is getting closer and closer. And looking at the background, this is a battle for 4th and 5th. So Quack is dropped down into 5th, he got overtakes by who is that? And just fell into the clutches of Dobos in 6th place. And Dobos looking down inside, can he get past? Not quite. And it looks like Quad don't have a good race pace. And we got a battle for the lead of the race between 1st, 2nd and 3rd. They're closing to each other. As we skip now to the end of lap number 3, and the lead of race just starts his lap number 4. So I think there's going to be a very close gap between the lead of race and Fakhri Zain. And yes, look at this, look on your screen. It's Arthur who leads the race at the moment. Fakhri Zain drops down into 2nd place. As you can see, there's a several car makes a move. And I just noticed the 4th, the 7th place, sorry, the 7th place. Hudson already moves up into 7. Overtakes Tauber. As you can see, we got cars side by side, but no overtake is done at turn number 4. So it's Arthur who leads from Fakhri Zain. Fantastic stuff. So it looks like, so we're going to watch the replay. How it looks like, it's Arthur gets the better speed, looking down inside, so close to contact. But he managed to keep his car. His control. No, they're going side by side. They're nearly going side by side. And Adam's going to join the party. So this is a very interesting race. So they are battling. Adam looks down inside, but not quite. And that's a replay. So Adam Cam is closing to Fakhri Zain. It looks like Fakhri Zain starts to lose his race pace. So Fakhri Zain defends the inside, and can he get past Fakhri Zain into the main straight on lap number 5? That's the question. So it's Arthur who leads. I think it looks like Arthur is increasing his gap to Fakhri Zain. This is a battle for the lead, and the car number 4, I think that is Sasha Banks, is about to join the battle. And here we are. Lap number 5 is underway. And how about Cam? Can he get past Fakhri Zain? I think it should be easy one. You get a better speed down inside and moves up into 2nd place. And then Cam moves up into 2nd place and Ross is in 4th. It's not Sasha Banks. So Adam Cam is moved up into 2nd. Fakhri Zain drops down into 3rd place, just loses 2 position in a space of 2 laps. So we got Rossi behind him, Cam Rossi closing to him. And as you can see, we got a car battling at turn number 4. And this is Ionescu defending his position. There's a lock up there by Ionescu. As you can see, there's a one of Brooklyn looking down inside of McLaren, but not quite to get his overtake done. As we're running on board with Fakhri Zain now, he loses to position to Rossi. So Fakhri Zain is dropping backward. What's happened to him? He just takes the lead of the race on lap number, on the first lap, but he's starting to lose position lap by lap. What happened to him actually? So it looks like Fakhri Zain have a problem maybe. As we see Dibaros looking down inside of Tauber, and Rins Jans is about to join the party. So we got a battle for 8th, 9th and 10th place at the moment. So it's Arthur who leads from Adam. Then Rossi moves up into 3rd place. So Rossi is in a podium position at the moment. Fakhri Zain drops down into 4th. So I believe the car running in 5th is closing to Fakhri Zain, I guess. But what I can say about Fakhri Zain race pace is not consistent. It's really great on the first lap, but his race pace is slightly dropped lap by lap. So it's Hunter, it's flying. It's a 1 second between the race leader and Adam Kemp. As we see now, battle for 8th place, the Boros versus Tauber. Versus Vincenzo, I should say, because he joins the battle. Now he gets Slipstream looking down inside. I believe not quite because he defends. Tauber defends inside. Boros trying to look it down inside, but not quite. But it looks like Tauber taking the corner slowly. That allowed the Boros to get closer with him. And it looks like Boros looking down inside. Turn number 4, can he get his overtake done? And Tauber defends. Tauber is aggressively defends. But this is not really working. Oh, we got car crash. Vettel is crash. Vettel is out from this race. We are going to see the replay. What happened to Vettel? He's running in 15, runs wide at turn number 3, and spun and crash into the barrier. And he is out from the race. Loses his right rear tire. Understeer. Loses the control. Nothing to do and crash into the tire barrier. Loses his right rear tire. And he is the first car out from this race. So, yellow flag on lap number 7. So Vettel is out from this race. As we're running about with the Boros now, looking down inside of Tauber. Tauber defense. It could be contact. So close to contact. Oh, they went so nearly to contact between them. Tauber is driving very slowly. He just holds up 2-3 cars behind him. So the Boros should get past him as quickly as possible into turn number 16, and he's about to complete his 7th lap, and he's about to start his lap number 8, the Boros versus Tauber. I think it should be easy, but I think the Boros is not closing to Tauber, so it looks like down inside goes Greenwood, moves up into 12th place. And the Boros, can he get past Tauber into turn number 4? Once again, Tauber covers the inside as usual. What a defensive driving by Tauber. Just holds the Boros and Jens behind him, and he's about to horse Sasha Banks. But it's a 1 second gap between Jens and Sasha. Behind Sasha is Greenwood, which is Jens' teammate. So the Boros switching the line, and it looks like, oh, there's a Jens nearly hits at the back of Boros. They were so close to contact between them. As we see now, Cha side by side with Muka. So Cha moves up into 14th place. As you can see, there's a car makes a move. I think that is one of the racing engineering. Just makes a move to move up a position. Same as Cha. And it looks like a car, Muka, loses some speed. And two cars behind him, it's getting closer. As we are running with Gomez now. So it looks like one of the cars looking down inside. Oh! Another circuit contact by Sam nearly hits the car in front of him. I believe that is Muka. So Muka is in 15, Sam in 16, and Gomez in 17th place. And see Sam gets a better speed now, that going side by side with Muka. Can he get his job done? Looking down inside, and Sam, I believe he moves up into 15th place. So Sam move another spot to improve his position at the moment. And Muka just fell into the clutches of Gabriel Gomez. So Gomez looking down inside. Now this is going to be the opportunity for Gomez to make some move on Muka. So he just choose the inside line, and Gomez moves up into 16th place to improve his position. That's, and there is Cha. Cha moves up into 13th place. So it's still Arthur who leads the race. So here it is, Cha moves up into 13th place. Overtakes one of the German driver, which currently running in 14th. And this is one of the Ice Spot Racing. Tries to overtake him. Riding with some now in front of his crest. There's a more overtakes at turn number one, so Sam not quite can get past crest in front of him. And Gomez is about to join the battle. We got a battle for 13, 14, 15. So this is a very interesting route. We got the driver battling with each other. We got many groups which battling at the moment. And here it is, the midfield group, I should say. Midfield groups battling in terms of the position. They are not racing for the points, but they are racing to improve at the position moment. So I think we've got a quite long way to go. We are on lap number 12. So you have 9 laps to improve your position into turn number 10. So they are closing to each other. And I think, to summarize, the overtaking opportunity is at turn number 1, majority at turn number 1 at this main straight. And this is the top 6. So the driver, the lead of race, starts his lap number 15. Arthur leads from Adam from Rossi in 3rd place. And it looks like the gap between 4th place Fakhri Zain and the 5th place Hudson is getting very close. Look at Hudson aggressively down inside. Can he get his job done? Fakhri Zain on the outside, and he loses position to Hudson. So Fakhri Zain drops down into 5th place. What an overtake. What an amazing overtake by Hudson. He just pushes Fakhri Zain to the outside and get his overtakes done. What a stuff by this Thailand driver. 5 laps remaining, we nearly to reach the closing stage of the race. Race 2 here in Spain. So I think the race is quite interesting, but as you can see, there's a not a special drama. You got only a crash, and this is a battle for 14th place. Lonely inside goes Gomez, moves up into 14th place. Now as you can see, now there's a group of cars. You got a Tauber's in 9th, it just holds up 5 car behind him. This is a very interesting. So I am looking forward to this amazing battle. You got battle between 9, 10, 11, 12 and 13th place between Tauber, Barros, Jens and his teammates behind him. 4 laps remaining. So this is going to be a very great action on the closing stage of this race. 4 laps remaining. And who's going to get his overtake done? As you can see, the driver's position on your left on the screen. So Arthur, who starts from pole position, is leading the race. And second place is Adam. So Rossi, he just improves 2 position. And fantastic by Hudson from 8th place, and now he's running in 4th. Fakhri Zain, he have a good start of the race. Takes the lead from Arthur and Adam. But his race pace, he just slightly dropped, starting on lap number 3. As we see now on your screen, a trains of the car. This is a Tauber train. It just holds up. And there's a lockup, goes Greenwood. So Greenwood locks up, and he's going to lose his couple of time. And Cha is closing to him. So 2 laps remaining, the legal race just starts his lap number 19. So this is going to be a very interesting battle with all these guys. So who will get the overtakes done? I don't think so, because they are far apart from each other. Final lap. Arthur is leading from Adam. Then you have Rose is in third place. And looks the top three. You can see top three in the screen. This is a very interesting race. I mean, this race is quite competitive. We don't quite see too many dominance in this race, because Pakrizain takes the lead, then Artery takes the lead back on lap number 5, and we got Adam is closing to Arthur, but I don't think so. I don't think he's get close anymore. And I think Trident Racing is about to get his second win. 2 out of 2. The race win by the Trident. But if this is going to... it's just too early to say about this. We got a few corners to go. Into turn number 10, 6 corners to go. He need to bring his car home safely if you want to win this race. Few corners to go. And Trident is about to win the second race of GP2 Offline Championship with the different drivers. So last week we have Trident wins. It's Cha who wins the race, and this time around Arthur takes the win in Spain. Behind him's Cam is a less than a second gap between Arthur and Cam. Rose is in third, Hudson's in fourth, and Frankie Zayn finishes 5th, Dobo's in 6th place, and Quark is about to cross line in 7th. And what a defensive drive by Tauber, is about to cross line in 8th place. Jal holds 5 car behind him, Barrows in 9th, Jens in 10th, Grandwood is in 11th. As you can see, there's a rest. Mukar 17th, Ionescu 18, and Hautala is about to finish last. So all 21 cars finish the race except for one of the Supernova, who crashes on lap number 7. So the race is over. So Arthur wins the race. So we are about to watch the race result. It's John Arthur wins from Adam Cam, less than a second. I believe that is 8 tenths of a second between the win of the race and Adam Cam. So we are going to watch the full race result. Here it is. John Arthur wins 30 minutes and 3 seconds. Trident's second wins in the season, 2 out of 2. Adam Cam is in second, Mario Rossi is in third, Spencer Hudson is in fourth. Fantastic drive by him, moves up from 8th place. Fakirzain's in 5th, Dobo's in 6th, Quartz in 7th, Talbot's in 8th. Great defensive by him. Barrows in 9th, Jans in 10th, his teammate Greenwood's in 11, Amachar, the last race winners in 12, Hakan Sam in 13, Gabriel Gomez 14, Sasha Bay 15, Crash in 16, Petro Mukar 17, Ionescu, McLaren, Brooklyn Hautala, and Vettel. So Vettel crashed on lap number 7. It's only the guy who didn't finish the race. And we are going to watch who sets the final race. I believe that is it Arthur? Because last time I saw the driver who set the first lap is on lap number 5 something. So let's see who set the first lap. That is Mario Rossi. Mario Rossi set the first laps from Hudson in 2nd, Gomez in 3rd, so Adam Cam's in 4th. So where is Arthur? Arthur's in 6th place. Arthur's in 6th in terms of the first lap. So Mario Rossi have a good pace from this result, I can say. Hudson too. Hudson have a good pace as well. Just made up 4th position today. As you can see the rest. Amacha 7, Dobos in 8, Fakrizain. So that's why Fakrizain 9th on the best lap. So Fakrizain don't have a good pace starting from lap number 3. And this is the race. Only Hautala 2.3 second. There's a... So that's only from me, as Shumi, so I am sorry due to many commentary error. So that's only the highlights for this race.